UvaldeRadio.net, your concert station. It's Robert McGill here with you. Good morning. And as we head into the weekend, man, lots of cool stuff going on. I'm telling you what, once Halloween hits, it's just like all a blur. And, you know, with family events and holiday stuff and shows, live music is back pretty much in Texas. And we are excited about a big show coming up this Sunday afternoon at the Graff 7A Ranch. As if the Graff Ranch wasn't just awesome enough on its own with the hayride, the maze. They've got a pumpkin patch, all kinds of good stuff for family and kids. But they've got live music in the dance barn. And this Sunday afternoon, the return of Allora Leonard. And guess what? I've got Allora on the phone. Welcome back, m'lady.
Hi! How are you?
I'm good. How you doing?
Doing great. Doing great.
You know what? I'm pretty sure we talked almost about exactly a year ago, because you did a gig.
Oh, my God. Yes.
Last fall, right? Yeah, yeah. So at that time, we had your latest single, Old Soul Girl, and we were playing it for a while. And since then, you've kind of really, you really started the radio promotion, and you're really getting this thing going now, aren't you?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I am. I just got an email that it's 61 on the chart.
Wow.
So we're slowly making our way up.
That is so cool. And now this is your debut single, right?
Yes, sir, it is.
Now, for those who don't know, who didn't hear the interview a year ago or maybe forgot because times are crazy, Allora Leonard, you are, okay, now see, you're from this area, right? But you moved away for a while. Give us your quick background again.
Right. So I grew up there in Hondo. You know, I went to the maze and whatnot. And then I moved to Colorado for a couple years. And then I came back to Texas and I lived outside of Fredericksburg.
Right. Very good, very good. So you know all about these parts here, and it's really cool that you've got a kind of blossoming career in country music. So we'll get into that, but let's talk about this now. First of all, on your website, it says you're 17 years old. Is that updated? Are you 17? Have you turned 18 since the update, or what? How old are you now? Because you're a young lady.
Yes, sir. So I'm still 17. Okay. I had my birthday back in June.
Very good. All right. So 17, you got a single out to radio. How much have you recorded so far in your career?
Well, Old Soul Girl was my first time to ever go into studio. Mm-hmm. And so I'm actually getting ready to go in for another project here really soon. So y'all will definitely be hearing about that.
Well, very, very cool. So let's go ahead and review. Let's talk about the recording. First of all, let's talk about the song Old Soul Girl. Now, you know, basically kind of one of the cool like aspects of your story is that you're a young girl, you know, but you've got this really mature, strong, soulful voice. And then the song really kind of, you know, taps into that whole kind of theme, you know, Old Soul Girl. It's cool. My daughter really digs the song. She's like, man, that girl sounds like she's 30 years old, and not as an insult, but you've got a really good, rich, deep, mature voice, you know? So let's talk about the early years. I mean, you're only 17, so they're still early years now, but let's tell us how you got into music, your influences, and what brought you to, you know, recording of Old Soul Girl.
Absolutely. So I grew up doing rodeo. I still do rodeo. And I was at some youth rodeos. And I sing to my horses. I've always sung to my horses. And I was getting ready to go in and compete. And the staff heard me sing. And they said, we need to get this little girl to sing the national anthem. And so I got started singing the national anthem at rodeos. And it just kind of grew from there.
Wow, very cool. So what was, so, you know, you're singing the national anthem at a few rodeos. I mean, did you ever sing at church or just, you know, with the family around Thanksgiving dinner table? Or, I mean, did you have any experience in performing in front of a crowd, whether it was just a small crowd or did you just, they just throw you right into the fire?
I really hadn't had any experience prior to that. After that happened, I did sing at church, entered up in some talent shows. So prior to that, I never performed in front of an audience.
Now, and what age was this all going down?
I was about 8 or 9.
Wow. Okay. So you were young. So, and at that age, you don't even have any control as to what you're really doing. Your mom and dad pretty much just go, look, you're going to sing, girl, right?
Well, honestly, my mom and dad didn't know that I could sing. I had some of these people just kind of grab me, get permission from my parents, and off I went.
So at that age, did you already know you could carry a tune pretty good?
I guess so. I don't know. I think as a kid, you don't really think about it.
Right.
And I just love to sing. And so I think at that point, I didn't care if I sounded good or not.
Now, what did these people, and you haven't really talked about who they are, but what did these people recognize? Was it the maturity in your voice or just the fact that, you know, you've got good tone and pitch, that kind of stuff?
You know, I'm not really sure. I think just, you know, you got this cute little girl and she can carry a tune, so let's grab her.
Let's prop her up. Let's put her up there and sing that. And of course, yeah. People eat it up, man. It's great. And honestly, we've talked about this before. I mean, singing the national anthem is kind of the gateway into a career in country music for many, many people. So very cool. So fast forward a few years, you get a song. Now, how did you get Old Soul Girl? Is it a co-write? Was it written for you? Tell us how you got the song.
So I had met with my producer, JT Hodges. And he and I wanted to start on a new project. And he was sending me some song ideas and whatnot. So we were writing songs at the time. And, you know, he was telling his buddies about me. And he said, well, she's an old soul. And he kind of got the idea, old soul girl. And so he had written about a verse and a chorus. And he sent it to me. And I loved it. And he and I called up on Zoom, and we finished the song together, and we ended up recording it about a month afterwards.
Now, I mean, it is a really pro recording. I mean, it really sounds great on every level. You know, the musicians, your voice, the song lyrically. I mean, it's just a really strong tune. And I mean, how do you tell me about the background on the recording process? Who'd you work with? And you know, how did that all come together?
So I had flown out to Nashville, and I worked with JT. I also worked with Casey Wozner, who had won a Grammy. And so that was really cool. And so I worked at his home studio there outside of Nashville. And I worked with some musicians from Little Big Town and Rascal Flatts, and we went out to Dark Horse Studios to go record with them. So the whole process was super fun. All the guys were very, very sweet to me, it being my first time in the recording studio. So I'm definitely very blessed that I got to have that experience.
Well, it's no doubt with that kind of team behind you that the record sounds like such good quality. Now, tell me this. I mean, that had to be kind of pricey. Did you have investors already at this point? Or did mom and dad, you know, open up the purse strings a little bit and just kind of really help you out there?
Well, both my mom and dad and I, we kind of piled up some money together, and we kind of went in there as a team.
Nice. Very good. All right. I mean, really, I mean, that's the way to do it. I mean, I couldn't tell you how many decent, you know, artists really kind of do themselves a disservice by not spending the money, you know, and just kind of doing it cheap. Because then your first impression is less than, you know, it could be. And this record just sounds amazing. So now, outside of the album, how about the video? I mean, you got a really good sharp video, too. Tell us how fun it was and what the experience was like for the video shoot.
So the video we had shot there at studio when I was recording. So it was up there in Nashville. And then I would say a month or two later, we got a friend of ours out in Colorado to come video me for some videos for my website. And we ended up kind of unexpectedly doing something for Old Soul Girl. And we just kind of had a bunch of fun with it. And I'm really happy with how it turned out. It was not what I expected it to be, but I'm super happy with it.
Now, when you say it wasn't what you expected, tell me, give us details on that.
So, originally when we had contacted him, we were going to put out some videos of me singing some of my other original music out onto my website without the intention of actually shooting a music video. And so, we just wanted a couple of little clips of me, like, on a horse and stuff like that. And, you know, we just kind of played around with it, and he compiled some of those clips together from Nashville and from what he shot. And he kind of compiled a music video, and I really liked it. And so we kind of launched the music video.
It's a really pro, you know, a video. And, of course, it does a great job of just really putting you in that legit Texas country setting. So, you know, you're there. You got bales of hay. You're on a horse. You know, you're doing all kinds of cool stuff. They showcase, you know, like your little rodeo belt. How much of that is that really what your life looks like on any given day?
Oh yeah. Absolutely. Day to day, I'm doing school, I'm on a horse, and then I go to a gig that night. That's usually what my life looks like.
Very, very cool. Again, we're talking to Allora Leonard. She's performing this Sunday afternoon. The website says 2 o'clock. You might go on a little bit after that, but 2 o'clock-ish. Try to be out at the Graff 7A Ranch in Hondo, home of the South Texas Maze. You mentioned this. I got to talk about this because Ken and Lori are great supporters of UvaldeRadio.net and, of course, great supporters of your music as well as other great Texas country artists. Go ahead and give us the shameless plug about Graff Ranch. You know, being that you're from Hondo, I'm sure you've been in the maze and done all the activities. What's your favorite parts about Graff Ranch?
Oh, shoot. The last time I played there, which is about almost a year ago, and I went on the slide, and that was a lot of fun.
Wow, that big old slide mountain. That's intimidating. I don't think I could do that. Actually, I don't think I could walk up the steps to get there. That's what the problem is. I'm all huffing and puffing. I need to slide down after that.
Hours walking up that. Yeah.
I legit got lost in that maze, though, like to where I was a little scared. You know, I'm a grown man. But yeah, it's a great time. So, what's your longest memory of being at the maze? I mean, did you literally go there like when you were a small child?
Yes. I remember being there, I think, for Halloween when I was 4 or 5, probably younger.
Wow.
I remembered whenever the maze was on the other side of the ranch, and they didn't even have the big slides. They had two little ones, you know, that would go on either side. And I remember whenever they had a corn chute, you know, and you would shoot corn at these hay bales, and that was a lot of fun. And so I definitely have very fond memories.
Wow. It's like you and Graff 7A Ranch have grown together. Wow. Cool.
Exactly.
Go to graff7aranch.com and get your tickets for the show again this Sunday afternoon at the Graff Ranch in Hondo, just a short drive from here in Uvalde. Again, Allora Leonard's on the phone. Great video, amazing song, just climbing up the charts. Again, to remind everybody, we talked about a year ago. What has the last year been for you like? I mean, you know, with pandemic and kind of in and out of being able to do shows, how have you stayed busy over the last year since the last time you played the ranch?
You know, me being 17, of course, I have schoolwork and stuff like that that I have to take care of. But, you know, over the pandemic, it's actually been really good for me, you know, and I've been able to grow a lot as a musician. And I booked over 150 dates this past year. So we were super excited about that. And I hope that I get to book more than that next year. So I was definitely able to be very fortunate and be able to grow as an artist this year.
Now, you tease that you've got new music coming. Are you using the same production team? Are you happy with your last single and going to use that same team, or are there going to be changes? And what kind of direction is your music going in?
You know, there are going to be a few changes. I'm going to be recording out in Austin.
Wow.
And, you know, I think you can expect some good country soulful music and some good original music.
Now tell me this, for those who have not seen you perform live, what can we expect Sunday afternoon at Graff Ranch? Is it going to be you and the guitar? You're going to have a full band? What's that setting and what's that set going to look like?
You know, it's just going to be me and the guitar. I'm going to play lots of songs that I've written and maybe a few covers that y'all might know.
Very, very good. All right, so I guess as we wrap it up, we'll get ready to play your song. And again, you guys can find the video on YouTube. We've also posted it on our Facebook page at Uvalde Radio. And go ahead and tell us your official websites, all the places we can find Old Soul Girl and all that good stuff.
You can find Old Soul Girl on Spotify and Apple Music and any streaming platform. You can find it on there. And also, if you want to see where I'm playing, like The Maze, you can look up my website, which is AlloraLeonardMusic.com, and you can see where I'll be playing at, what times, etc. And you can also find me on Instagram, Facebook, and even TikTok.
Well, very good. Well, it's so cool catching back up with you, Allora. We're looking forward to seeing you Sunday afternoon. Me and my daughter are going to try to get up there and see you. So we haven't seen you live yet, but we are trying to fix that immediately, okay?
Absolutely. We would love to see y'all there.
All right, then. Let's go ahead and do it. This is Old Soul Girl. This is Allora Leonard. Don't miss her Sunday at the Graff Ranch. This is UvaldeRadio.net, your concert station. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
I like the dust on the Norton Road. I like a beat-up Silverado. I like to ride with the windows rolled down. Feel the wind blow. I like the look of a stoplight town. I like the feel of a classic sound. I like taking the long way around. I'm telling you now, I'm an old soul. Living ease it down, take it on back. Ooh, I like it just like